What part of your brain controls your emotions? Let's talk about it. As a therapist, I like to talk about emotions all the time. That's what us therapists do, right? So it's important to understand how emotions work. When you understand your brain, it helps you learn how to regulate your emotions. So I'm going to show you the parts of your brain that are important to understand and how to actually regulate your emotions. Our brains are really cool. So you're going to want to listen to the end of this video because you'll understand the whole process of what's happening when you have an emotion, and you'll learn how to regulate it and actually be able to choose the behaviors that you want in your life. I want you to think about an alligator for a minute. When a gazelle comes down to the water, the alligator doesn't have much emotion. It just thinks food, and it goes and gets the food. That alligator has a reptilian brain. It has instinctual things that happen that propel it to act in a certain way. Now, we humans also have what's called our reptilian brain. Now, I'm going to use my brain as the example. If you look at my brain here, the middle part of my brain, that's called my limbic system. That's my reptilian brain. That's designed to help me survive. It's my instincts. Our emotions are formed and triggered in our limbic system. The function of our emotion is to help us with survival. So we have whatever emotion it is, fear, shame, anger, happiness, those things are communicating to us about what's good for us for our survival. That happens in our limbic system, and it's pretty automatic. We're lucky. As humans, we don't just have a reptilian brain. We have this other thing called our mammalian brain. We're actually mammals. I don't know if you knew that or not, but we're actually mammals. Now, this mammalian brain does something different than our reptilian brain. Viktor Frankl said there's a space between stimulus and response where we have power to choose. Now, what he's talking about is the difference between automatic instinct and actually choosing what we want to do in our life. So if I have a cheeseburger in front of me that smells really, really good, and I think, well, I ate 2 cheeseburgers already for lunch, but man, I want to eat that. My mammalian brain can say, that's probably not very good for you, so why don't you lay off the cheeseburger? My reptilian brain would say, gobble it down, eat it up right now. So there's tools that we can use to get out of our limbic system and get up here to the front part of our brain, to our frontal lobe. And in our frontal lobe, that's where mindfulness exists. That's where logic and reason exist. And we're able to create space between stimulus and response. Think about Pavlov's dogs for a second. He rings a bell, he gives them a treat. Rings a bell, gives them a treat. And they salivate every time he gives them a treat. Now, what he discovered was their limbic response, their reptilian brain response. When I ring that bell, I can automatically get a certain response from them. Now, we are like Pavlov's dogs. Our brains are ready to do certain things when certain things happen, but we can actually slow it down and change what we decide to do before we just automatically respond. We might have certain reactions in our body. We might desire to do certain things, but we can stop ourselves and actually choose. We can have power over our brain rather than our brain having power over us. Before I walk you through how to have power over your brain, I want you to subscribe to my channel and please like this video. In order to regulate your emotions and control your behaviors, it all comes down to mindfulness. When you have a limbic response, you go unconscious, you're automatic, you're responding. When you stop and you get mindful, and when I say mindful, what I mean is you get present in this moment. You become aware of what's happening around you. You can feel things, you're grounded, you sense things. When you're mindful, then you actually can stop and decide what you want to do. So one of the first things to do to get mindful is practice awareness. Be aware of your body. Be aware of what's going on around you. Stop and just feel your breath. Your breath helps with mindfulness because you're always breathing and that's always happening in the moment. So become aware of what's going on in your body. Become aware of who's around you and just try to be in this moment. The next thing to do to control your response is to accept everything. Push away nothing. So allow whatever is happening to happen. The reason is when you start to judge everything, you start to judge yourself. I shouldn't feel this, or I should be this way, or I should be that way. You're spinning off in an emotional response. But when you are aware of what's going on and you accept it, you say, oh, interesting. Get curious about what's happening and accept it rather than be resistant to it and fighting against it. The third thing to do is to acknowledge it, and even acknowledge it verbally. When you say something out loud, you're moving it from your limbic system, from your reptilian brain into your mammalian brain. So when you say, oh, I'm feeling sad or lonely, or I'm feeling really happy right now, that's interesting. I'm aware of that. I know you might be the weird one talking to yourself, but saying things out loud is helpful in moving those thoughts from your automatic response up into your more conscious brain. After you've acknowledged it, then assess the situation. And what I mean by that is you can look at what's going on. You can understand your emotion. Listen to your emotion. What's your emotion telling you? Is it telling you to run and hide? Is it telling you to be aggressive? But what is that emotion telling you? And now that you're up here in your mammalian brain, you can stop and say, yes, I'm going to go forward with that behavior. Or no, I'm not going to go forward with that behavior. Just like my cheeseburger example. No, I don't want to eat the cheeseburger, even though my body is telling me that I want to. This last step is really important. So you've accepted what is, you've acknowledged what is, you've assessed the situation, and now look at your emotion and ask yourself a question. Is the emotion grounded in reality? Is it actually helping me for my survival? And if it's not grounded in reality or based in reality, then you're probably having what's called a trauma response. You're having an emotional response because of your past experiences. And if that's happening, then you may need to act opposite to what that emotion is telling you to do. So let me give you an example. Let's say that your teacher calls you out in class and they say, how come you never do the right thing? Your trauma response might be to please your teacher and tell them why everything's okay. But in that moment, what might be the most effective thing to do is to actually advocate for yourself and to stand up to your teacher and say, please don't talk to me like that. That's an opposite response from what you're used to doing. And that's because that emotion is not based in this moment in reality. If the emotion is based in reality, if the emotion is very pertinent to what's going on, and you're mindful that emotion is telling you something, then don't act opposite to the emotion. Listen to it and assert yourself. So let me give you an example. If I see a child wandering across a busy road and the bus is coming to hit the child, I feel fear. I feel some anxiousness. I feel an urge to go get that child. So I run across that road and I tackle the child and I save the child's life. That emotion was awesome. That emotion was really, really good. And I'm glad I listened to that emotion because the danger was real and I followed through with it. Your brain is like a muscle. Mindfulness is key. So the more you can practice mindfulness, you can do it through meditation, doing yoga, guided imagery, just breathing every single day, the more you're conditioning your brain to be able to be mindful, to be able to step up in those moments when you need it the most. So practice mindfulness, because in those crucial moments, it's hard to do it. But if you have the capacity because you've worked that muscle out, it helps you so much in those moments. If this video has been helpful on understanding your brain and understanding your emotions, then check out my other video, How to Be Emotionally Connected to Your Spouse.